and let's not. Are you hearing me? You're feeding me. All you're feeding is light. Two bells have to call Sister Grace for two more. And when she's pleased. What are we offering to God? And do you think he's pleased with that which you're giving him? God doesn't matter the plate of food. My God, if the tray is dirty, I won't eat it. How do we expect to give God whatever and expect God to take it? David has anointed, appointed, elected, and selected as he is. Lay it aside and you fight the battle that you have. And let me know how it goes. I said, upon this rock we'll build my church. And the what? Gates for the kingdom. Gates, gates, gates. Say gates.
Gates.
Gates. Every one of us have a gate. Has a gate.
Yes.
You have an eye gate.
Yes. Come on. Come on.
You have an ear gate.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes.
And then there's a gate below our waist.
Yes.
You getting what I'm saying?
Yes.
All right. I know there's no children here.
No.
Well, there's a gate. And we have to be selective in what we open the gates.
Come on, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Because some gates were meant to be closed. Oh God, my Lord, Holy Ghost, what are you doing to me? 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 Sometimes who we invite in is not an intruder. Because you invited him in. It was an invitation. Do what she's supposed to do. But he's doing what he's not supposed to do. Some of the biggest troublemakers in the church are those who are not doing what they're supposed to do. And they're spending their time.
Come on.
I know that I'm doing what they're supposed to do.
Yes.
The eye gate was open. To that which did not belong to Israel. Brother, your wife must be your wife. There shouldn't be any other woman.
Jesus.
One woman.
Yes, sir.
Not several. And every other woman must be cut off because you have one. And we have one soul.
One soul.
And nothing should get between our soul and our
Savior. Hallelujah.
But his eyes left the something that didn't belong to him.
Yes, come on.
He had everything in the kingdom, but the kingdom could not satisfy that high gate.
Come on.
The high gate wants to take to the balcony that which is not supposed to be there in the first place.
Come on. Hallelujah. Jesus.
Then we move to the air gate. Who's that? Not every inquiry is an inquiry.
Come on.
Watch what you allow in your ears, church.
Come on.
Because what you have in your ears affects who's on the throne.
Yes, come on. Jesus.
When you process this, it moves to the heart gates. And it's channeled. It's channeled. It's channeled. So we move from a spirit of idleness to a spirit of idolatry. Because he left his God. Because if we're not doing the things of God, we're doing the things of the devil. Idleness moves to adultery. Don't you know that this, don't you know who this woman is? This is Uriah's wife.
Yes.
This is one of your chief's servants' wives.
Yes.
Bring her to me. They tried to warn him. But you can't argue with authorities.
Come on.
I can't see everything. Because I'm man. I'm flesh. We're leaders. And there's things that God will place in our spirits, things that God will place in our minds. God is leading the man of God, the men of God, God is leading. But God does not show the men of God everything. Because if he showed the men of God everything, then the men of God would be equal to God. Sometimes, Holy Ghost of God, things need to happen first. And then the men of God do what they're supposed to do. But in the meantime and in between time, we're supposed to pray for the men and women of God. Say, God, be the eyes within the eyes. Be the ears within the ears. Touch their hearts, oh Lord. Give them wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. Because there's some authorities, amen, you have no power dealing with or changing or influencing. But there's an authority, well, in all of the authority, more than that, the authority of God. So they took him in, he stepped in, and went on the merry way, or so they thought. So we move on from the spirit of idleness, the spirit of idolatry, the spirit of conspiracy. Conspiracy. We are planning. The spirit of sabotage. Where did the man of God go? Where did it start? High gate open on a balcony. Because a balcony not meant to stay there and lock up. You're meant to, in the balcony, you survey.
Survey. Come on.
You don't select. You survey. And the heights there, you don't stay there too often. They're supposed to see the enemies. But since you see the enemies, one look was all it took for the man of God to get hooked. One look. And because it was a time of purification, he wasn't missing a beat. She didn't wipe up. So he saw all the way up. But this was something that he was seeing. And moving away from what you see.
Come on. Hallelujah.
You may see things you don't like, but you have to have in your mind that you don't like it. But if you see it and like it,
come on.
Then that which you see has selected you.
Come on. Yes.
The spirit of conspiracy. I'm pregnant. I'm pregnant. I got it covered. I got it covered. I got it. What?
Cover
up! That's the problem. He was not convicted.
Come on.
When you're convicted, you don't cover up. When you're convicted, you make it right.
Yes. Come on.
But he didn't make it right. Because guess what? He didn't see that he did. And just some of the biggest things the devil put gloss on your eyes because you can't see yourself. The hardest people to deal with is people that can't see themselves. They're trying to tell people you need a new equipment. No. And in your head you say, take two. Because they can't see them. You're always the one that want to get up in your face.
Come on.
And hold lengthy conversations.
Come on.
There was a woman that was talking up in my face, and my God, I tried to avoid, but see, every time I turn, she kept on turning with me. She kept on turning with me, kept on talking. She was 71 years old, her breath smelling, she was 75. Sin is always more than you.
Come on.
But you need to know from the spirit of conspiracy. He was a man of God. And wrapping up, he was a man of God. A man of God was the kingdom duties. But instead he was concealing and he was covering up because he couldn't see himself. He said, man, listen, go home. You're in the bag of tire. Go home. That's what he told you, right? Go home, man. Go rest. Spend time with your wife. The man went home, but guess what? He didn't go inside the house. He stayed at the porch. Because he said, how can I do this? And I gotta be in battle. I'm gonna leave my comrades. Church of God, when you realize that you're not serving alone. You have people with you that are depending on you. Jackson, I'm depending on you. Highgate, I'm depending on you. To work together to build. And when he saw that that was not enough, he told the general, put Uriah in the battle. But put him in the hottest part of the battle. Put him in the most intense part of the battle. Ambition would have taken him there anyways, because he'd want to go there to fight, but he couldn't manage. I said, and when he's there, when he falls, listen to the direction. When he falls, leave him there. Don't come after him. What kind of king? Believe him now. What kind of leader would leave the ministry to die? Set him up a a spirit of conspiracy leading to the spirit of butchery. If I can destroy your tongue, is this tongue? This tongue is a new tongue. Because I have no honor. I say that cause is sleeping with me. Let go. How awful that is. Because it's sleeping with me. I say it to you. But I spread it. I test it. To be one. Who Skypes it to Jamaica. Are you hearing me? And I stayed right here and said it. But the damage is done.
All over, come on.
Wildfire. And if we don't get sin under control, our ways under our control, we will blaze in sin and destroy everything. But I want to let you know God doesn't cover up nothing. When no one saw it and years went by and time went by and the baby was born in the morning when a funeral procession went on and the baby, when everything seemed as it was just right. But that's how God moves when you think it's peace and safety. Some study with that in the cool, the red empty, easy scanking, scanking it slow, easy scanking, and didn't know that there was a knock on the door. I thought there was no knock, there was a man of authority that came up. Nathan, let me tell you something. When you have authority, you don't need to knock. Oh! When you have authority, you don't need to knock. Don't just start a prayer group in the church. He doesn't, he don't need no permission, but God gave it to him. If God raised you up on the cat to feed the hungry, you don't have to ask for permission because God gave you the permission. Because God gave you the authority. He says, listen, I have something to tell you. Say on, my brother, say on. He said, there was a man that had David. But there was another one that had this one little man. And the man that had everything took the one little man. David, knowing what he was as a shepherd boy, stood up, said he should be killed. Isn't it amazing how people can bring forth righteous judgment and sentencing on everybody else? But they can't see themselves. Pride, take the beef and pride to get away. Satan's trying to see us from pride. Some of us have taken Satan for a ride. Because we allowed him in. Because he wasn't an intruder. He was an invited guest. We allowed him to the living room of our hearts. We allowed him to roll around in our master bed, master's master bedroom. We've allowed him. He's not an intruder. He was an invited guest. With me. It's a lady Sunday. Stand to your feet.
You are a man.
Invite